If you need to build an interface that people can interact with your data, but you have some strong needs for representing dates, then you're gonna love this video because I'm breaking down for you how you can use Noloco to build your own custom no-code app and display dates in three different ways. I'm talking about calendar, timeline, and Gantt charts inside of Noloco apps. So if that's of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting, where we help you to get the most out of your no-code tools. Noloco is one of our favorite front-end options. You could be storing data in SmartSuite or Airtable, and if you need to give people access, limited access, to some sort of portal, and you want to change the way they see that data, you want to make sure that you can control what they edit, what they see, all of those different components, you're going to love building in Noloco. Now, as I mentioned already, we are going to be diving into the three different view types to illustrate dates and times in a way that makes sense for the users, depending on your needs. But before we get into it, I first want to invite you to join me for automation training. No-code automation is one of the most powerful skills that you can learn because when you build in no-code automation tools, they will do all of those mundane, repetitive tasks in the background for you so that you no longer have to waste your precious time doing mind-numbing work. So if you want to first learn the foundational components of building no-code automation, I don't care what tool you use, this training is going to help you. Check it out at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. Now, without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. Follow along with me in Noloco. If you don't already have an account, please consider using our affiliate link that will also be where you found this video. It's a great way for you to show some love back to the channel. All right, hopping in, first I'm going to show you my Airtable database. So I've built this in Airtable. I've got projects and tasks, simple enough. Projects here, start date, end date. They've got a status, they're assigned to somebody. And most importantly over here, they're linking to tasks. Now on the second table, on my tasks, obviously we have the project that they relate to. We're gonna see the task name, the start and end date for that task. And also I wanna highlight, if we scroll all the way over, we've got a dependency here. So this dependency field is gonna be critical for the third of our views in Noloco, where we're showcasing that Gantt element. Before we can do task two, this one right here, it relies on the completion of something else. In this case, task one. So we've linked back to the same table. This is a self-linking table where tasks is linked to tasks, and we do this in the case where we have an internal dependency within our table. So now that we understand what we're looking at in terms of data, let's flip on into Noloco, and I want to start with just our tasks. So over here, this is just a standard view of tasks. This is a grid-like view, and as you can see, it's not really that helpful, right? It's not helpful in the sense that I don't know when these tasks are coming due in a visual way that makes sense to me. So let's dive into the first type, and that is the calendar. So I've built this calendar view for us here. This is using the exact same data in Airtable, but here we're able to see this on a calendar. We've mapped it with a start and an end date, and most importantly, we can tell what project those tasks are assigned to because Noloco has automatically color-coded them for us. So we can see over here, task 14, then going into task 15 in purple because that is all the same project that these components are assigned to. Now we can also open these up. We can drill into the particular record. So as I just clicked task 15, we can view the details on it and we have full control over these details. So whatever we want to have showing up here on this card, that's entirely up to us. Also note that we can have an action so that as somebody has clicked into this, they can take some sort of action step. And by default, that action is just to open up the detail of that task. So I've now drilled into task 15 and I can do that quite easily. And of course, I can go back on my left-hand side here and take another view of my calendar when I'm done. Now, at the end of this video, I'm going to show you the setup behind the scenes, but there's two more views I want to also share with you before we move on. So the next one here is going to be our task timeline. And here we just see our tasks in a pretty standard timeline. So instead of having that calendar view type, we can track over the days in a horizontal type of view. So we can see here that this task is starting right around the beginning of February and ending around the 14th or 15th. Again, we can drill into it by clicking. We have the same components that I shared with you in the last view. So we can open it up again. We have full control over the information that's being shared here when we drill into that task. Now, lastly, very similar to this view is our third view, the Gantt. And this is an important one that I want to stress because this is one of the key reasons you might choose to use Noloco for your front-end application. And the reason being, Airtable does not yet support Gantt views inside of Airtable interfaces. So if you have a strong need for some internal project and you have this interface capability in Airtable, but you can't bring in the Gantt chart and you're frustrated, well, my friend, you might consider Noloco because it offers this. So here we see that we have the dependency lines showing up, very similar to the timeline view with the additional advantage of having those dependency lines. So we can track and see that there's something else that's going to come after this. It's task 9. You know, where is that dependency? What is this reliant upon? We've got all of those lines kind of showcasing around. So let's take a look on the back end now and see how we set these different things up. Let's go now inside the app itself. Now, I want to point out that we can only see this because we are in that builder type mode, but I'm going to click on the icon down here, and this is the back end as I'm building in Noloco. So here I am on the calendar view, and in order to select this component, I can click it, or I can come down to the page and see the collection element. Now on the right hand side of my screen, these are the options, setups, general components that make the calendar view. So what I've done here is, of course, I choose the layout to be calendar. That's simple enough. I can give it a title, so I can say something like calendar. I can give it a subtitle. Let's go subtitle here. And you'll see this now popping up here at the top of this element that's added to the interface. And down here, I also have a cover photo. I can do a URL, upload one or none, which is what I've chosen now. But for the setup, and this is the important part, we are taking the start date in Airtable, and that's going to be the start date of the event on our calendar. We're mapping the end date to the end date on our calendar. And of course, we choose a default view as well. So I can choose, you know, week if I want to. I'm going to see things much more compressed. I could look at even just the work week or even day by day. If you've got your tasks down to the hour and you want to see that mapped out, this would be a great option for you. Now, for me, I'm tracking tasks over a long period of time, so a month makes perfect sense. And then lastly, I want to go with a title field and a grouping. So the title field is here. This is how we're going to name every element on our calendar. And lastly, we're doing the grouping. And so as I mentioned, we grouped by the project that the task is linked to, and that then chose the color for that project so that we can kind of track, oh, all these tasks are interrelated. Now let's move on to the next one. That would be the timeline view. Very similarly here, we select the collection here, and in the general, we choose the layout of timeline. And again, we have some different choices like title, subtitle, and then also the photo. But most importantly, down here, we're setting it up again, mapping it to the data with a start date, end date, a default view. So how much do we want to drill into the timeline, just as we did with the calendar, and choosing that title field, and again, the grouping of the different tasks. In our case, we are grouping by project. Now, I also want to point out that this is where we control other components like actions. So for us, we're enabling the capability of dragging and dropping the dates so that people can update that information. If I were to say, ooh, you know what, this was not supposed to be starting on the 16th, for example, I can now drag it over and make it, let's say, whatever this was, the 7th or whenever I let it go. And that will be reflected in the data in the background, so long as we've enabled event drag and drop. Now, lastly, let's pop on into the Gantt and select our component here. And we're going to drill into the types here again. This time we are choosing the Gantt layout. And the only difference here is when we scroll down, we're going to see the exact same component start and, you know, the default view, etc. But it's the dependency field that the Gantt has that is unique. And this is where we get that mapping where we're seeing, hey, this particular thing depends on something else that preceded it. And so that's where we get those lines and the Gantt dependency. And this is ultimately what makes it a Gantt chart and not just a typical timeline. So as you can see, a lot of different ways for you to visualize that date data, say that three times fast, on your Noloco apps. I hope you got a ton of value from this video and perhaps give Noloco a shot if you think that it could solve the problems you might be facing for your no-code apps. I know we went quickly, but if you have questions I did not address, be sure to drop them below. And in the meantime, my friend, keep on building.